Hey everyone, what's happening everyone, welcome back to the channel. Dan Steven here for another reaction. In this reaction we're going to be doing some Eminem. So we started doing this thing as before the pandemic where we started looking back at old Eminem songs. Just because like I think we were just doing this new shit and we're getting a lot of requests. A lot of people slapping us as well.
Yeah, because we're probably maybe a bit more critical of Eminem than we ever really mean to be, like.
Aye, so a lot of people were saying, I think we got a few comments saying, like, you aren't real Eminem fans or some shit. And we're like...
I love that. Like, who the fuck are you? do you have to join some sort of club or something?
Yeah, you know, membership. You pay monthly for his fucking...
That's mad.
His monthly album.
It's mad how people just associate themselves with other things. Like, Eminem doesn't... Like, you're nothing to Eminem.
Yeah.
Relax.
Yeah, I always think people become obsessed with people. Like, even people, like, who make, like, say, like an Instagram account, just, like, for fan photos of Eminem or something. She's like, why do you want to do that yourself?
It's weird. And, like, I've enjoyed Eminem's music for most of my life.
My whole life. And I can't remember a time where he wasn't involved in my life.
But it's okay not to like some. And it's okay to like, but it's, like, it's weird because you kind of get attached to people do everything.
Yeah.
And you just constantly try to justify everything that they do. You're like, no, that song is actually a bit shit.
Yeah, when we say, like, Eminem's released too many albums, like, no, he hasn't. He's released 3 albums in 5 years. That's too many albums. Simmer down. Like, we're actually writing this. We're not saying he's bad. He's amazing. We're talking about it beforehand. His lyrics has just got even better. Yeah.
His ability to rap is, like, rhyme schemes is everything that his flow is incredible. But for me, my biggest problem with Eminem recently is that it's just the beats that go with associated with his songs that can be really cheesy. Yeah. And I've never really loved rap that has, like, no disrespect to someone like Rihanna doing the chorus, because it throws me off a wee bit. I've never really liked that kind of thing. But
you want to hear that part, you want to hear Eminem, not Eminem featuring someone else sometimes.
Yeah, but I think, then again, some of them songs are good, but like, we're doing Clean Out the Closet today, and this is like an old school Eminem song.
Yeah.
And I haven't really sat and listened to it in years, like, but
just because you say a song isn't good doesn't mean his lyrics aren't good.
Yeah.
And the way he says them aren't good. Yeah. A song is, like, so much different. Moving parts now.
He's so many, like, especially his recent songs, like, so many, they're so bar heavy that you think you know what they're about, and then you really look at the lyrics and you're like, this, when he says this, he actually means this, but he could also mean this. Like, everything has, like, triple meanings.
Yeah.
I'm like, it makes me think, how the fuck did he write that?
Yeah.
But I think in his early days, I don't think he was
that complex.
Yeah, he wasn't as complex.
He still was. He still, like, no, he threw in some things there, some curveballs in there, but it wasn't too, as you said, heavy in that sense. It always was just quite straightforward. Like,
you know exactly what he's talking about.
We know what the song's about. Yeah. But it's clean his closet.
Mm-hmm.
Spring cleaning. All right, we'll give it a go, see how it goes.
Where's my snare? I have no snare.
Does he still work with Dr. Dre?
Yeah, I think he does. Like,
does he still make his beats and all? No,
I don't know. I've actually no idea, man, to be honest. But the beat in this is amazing. This is what I mean. Like, it's
so simple.
It's so atmospheric as well.
Yeah,
it's brilliant.
Here are my headphones. There you go. Yeah.
You forget how young he actually is here? Like, early 30s, just.
Have you ever been hated or discriminated against? I have. I've been protested and demonstrated against. Picket signs for my wicked rhymes. Look at the times. Sick is the mind of the and kid that's behind. All this commotion, emotions run deep as oceans exploding. Tempers flaring from parents. Just blow them off and keep going. Not taking nothing from no one. Give them hell long as I'm breathing. Keep kicking ass in the morning and taking names in the evening. Leave them with the taste of sour as vinegar in their mouth. See, they can trigger me, but they'll never figure me out. Look at me now, I bet you're probably sick of me now. Ain't you, mama? I'ma make you look so ridiculous now. I'm sorry, mama, I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry, but tonight I'm cleaning out my closet.
I always find this song a bit confusing, in the sense that obviously it's about his mum. Obviously, he's like slaying off his man all through. I think he's literally apologized for the song and shit, but like, the chorus, he's saying sorry to her.
Yeah.
But in the verses, he's just fucking going at her.
But I think he's sorry that he's killing her, basically.
Yeah. All right. But part of me was just like, is he saying sorry to her?
No, he's definitely not. But it's like, I think this, it's so dark, and I think that's why this song was such a massive thing, because Eminem has a lot of shock value rap, right? Like, in a lot of songs where it'll just be a standard song, and then he'll throw in a lyric or a line that's like dissing someone. But this is a whole song dedicated to his mum about his life. And like, there's so many people that would listen to that and related to him growing up, and just watching Eminem. And you never really got an artist like that. He just literally fully talked about himself in a record. And you're like, fuck, you really get to know him.
Yeah, he opened himself up to the public. And I think that's why a lot of people related to him. Not related to him in the sense that, but just kind of had a connection with Eminem, because you kind of seen this successful, multi-fucking-million-fucking-whatever-he-is, like. But he's so fucking exposed, and he's so fucking vulnerable to everyone, like, and he talked about his fucking childhood, his fucking ma's dad not being there and all, and him himself being, obviously a drug addict and shit, so you felt like you empathized with that person, and you kind of like, I like you more than these other fucking pop stars on MTV, you know what I mean? But for me, see this video, like, this video obviously shows you that he's killed his mum, he's burying her, but if I listen to the lyrics, it doesn't really say that. So it's like the video adds so much more, which is good as well, because usually videos take away from the actual song. I think this actually adds to the actual song, and it kind of paints what he's trying to say. As you said, he's saying sorry for killing her, but if you listen to the lyrics, he doesn't actually say he killed her.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
One more time. I said I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. But tonight I'm cleaning out my closet. I got some skeletons in my closet, and I don't know if no one knows it. So before they throw me inside my coffin and close it, I'ma expose it. I'll take you back to 73, before I ever had a multi-platinum selling CD. I was a baby, maybe I was just a couple of months. My father must have had his panties up in a bunch, as he split down on second thought. I just wished he would die. I look at Haley and I couldn't picture leaving her side. Even if I hated Kim, I'd grit my teeth and I'd try to make it work with her. At least for Haley's sake, I maybe made some mistakes, but I'm only human. But I'm man enough to face him today. What I did was stupid, no doubt it was dumb, but the smartest shit I did was take the bullets out of that gun. Cause I'd have them, and I would've shot Kim and them both. It's my life. I'd like to welcome y'all to the Eminem show. I'm sorry, mama.
Part there, I don't know what actually went on, like, but he's like, thank fuck I took the bullets out of that gun, because he's saying like, I would have killed someone, you know, like he's saying like, trying to hide the fact that I was talking about
killing Kim.
Yeah, what?
He's talking about shooting Kim.
As he said, he's like, obviously there's a situation where he says, thank God I took the bullets out of the gun, because I would have killed them. Like, I literally would have shot Kim and them both, whatever the person is. Like, he's like,
must
literally
be Healy he's talking about. I don't know.
Who?
Healy.
Fuck.
But
that
I don't know.
That is darker, isn't it?
But for me, like, I'm thinking about this song and thinking about, like, because we were so young when this came out.
We didn't understand how big this song actually was in terms of what he was saying, him as a person and globally.
But as, like,
how it impacted people.
As a young boy, like, listening to this type of music, you kind of felt like such a rebel or something, because you knew, like, my dad did not want me to listen to this type of music growing up. And that's the same, and he talks about that in White America, how, like, so many, like, young, like,
fans,
young fan, like young white kids from like suburban areas, like middle class families, are in their house just listening to Eminem, and you know their parents aren't helping. And there's such a rebellious tone to that, as like a young boy wanting to listen to that, and your man's like, I'm not getting you, that says parent affection on the thing, blah blah blah, and you're like, no, we're not cleaning up my closet, man.
Well, there's something about Eminem and his art, you know, I mean, it's so, like, regardless if you're a fucking rich kid listening to this song, it shines through. Like, what he's trying to say, change through. You know what I mean? And that's why it's so good.
Yeah, I like that he talks about it a lot. He probably had a responsibility when he started getting really famous, because he's such a big following, but he also had a really young following. Young teenage boys, girls, whatever. But, like, I also kind of, I've always liked him, he just kind of he made the music that he wanted to make, rather than, I need to, like, tamper down a wee bit here because I'm influencing like a load of young kids.
He probably got worse when he was like told by like MTV and then so the record label calm it down. He's like, no, I'm gonna fucking actually go a step higher or fucking
He talks about more. That in Sing for the Moment. It's like he thinks he says stuff like, this is my life. I'm just like talking about it. Like that's what we do. You know what I mean? I'm not talking about like he didn't have a fucking Disney childhood.
And is he one of the first? Obviously, he's not the first rapper, but he's one of the first rappers to really expose himself to the public and kind of let it all out there. Like, he talked about depression, suicide, anxiety, from the early on. Now we all talk about that there, and we celebrate people who actually come out and talk about the person. But he was fucking doing it from like the get go, like saying, "I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Yeah. I have too much money. I don't know what's going on there. I hate my wife, my ex wife, and my mom. I want to kill her. Yeah. But here, this is what I'm just going through the motions here."
Yeah,
and that's what it feels like when he's writing it down. It's like you're going through the emotions with him through this song.
Yeah,
like he's almost writing it down. Doesn't know what he's gonna say next. He's just writing it down.
Yep.
And that's why he's amazing lyricist.
I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. But tonight, I'm cleaning out my closet.
One more time.
I said I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. But tonight, I'm cleaning out my closet. Nah, I would never diss my own mama just to get recognition. Take a second to listen, fool, you think this record is dissing. But put yourself in my position. Just try to envision witnessing your mama popping prescription pills in the kitchen. Pretend that someone's always going through a person missing, going through public housing systems, victim of Munchausen syndrome. My whole life I was made to believe I was sick when I wasn't, till I grew up. Now I blew up, it makes you sick to your stomach, doesn't it? Wasn't it the reason you made that CD for me, ma? So you could try to justify the way you treated me, ma? But guess what, you're getting older now, when it's cold when you're lonely. And Nathan's growing up so quick, he's gonna know that you're phony. And Haley's getting so big now, you should see her, she's beautiful. But you'll never see her, she won't even be at your funeral. See, what hurts me the most is you won't admit you was wrong. Do your song, keep telling yourself that you was a mom. But how dare you try to take what you didn't help me with it. Remember when Ronnie died and you said you wished it was me? Well, guess what? I am dead, dead to you as can be. I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. But tonight, I'm cleaning out my closet.
One more time.
I said I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. But tonight, I'm cleaning out my closet.
Man, that song and that video is just fucking class.
It's pretty good.
It's so fucking good, isn't it? Like, and I was just sitting there thinking about this, like, how big Eminem actually is at this time and now. Like, he's literally like one of the biggest pop stars, rock stars ever.
Yeah,
like, you're talking about like the Freddie Mercury's, the Elvis, Johnny Cash's. Eminem's up there.
So he's kind of, it's weird, Eminem's careers went from this personal life. He's done a lot of jokey songs and shit as well, but he's done a lot of serious stuff. And then now he's so big that his music is now about how he's almost not appreciated.
Yeah.
Because it's
he's like, too big
he's
almost.
He's too big. It's like he gets diamond sales. He sells millions and millions of songs, but people are still like, he's not as good anymore. And he's like, he set the bar so high that his latest albums need to be like groundbreaking to be considered a success. Whereas like his albums outsell every other album ever that anyone else could make, and it's still like
he still says he's not appreciated.
It's almost like that's what happens. You people start to say with the Mr. Old you, like, I want you to go back to how you used to be. It's like, it's what happens. It's like, you've changed.
No, we've all changed.
Or it's like they would say like, he's never gonna be. He's never gonna make it. And then he makes it, and it's like, he's not as good as he used to be.
Yeah,
like, I don't know what to do anymore.
Always, he's been saying that since like the first and second album. Even after the second album came out, because we like the first album. It's like, fuck, there's always gonna be critics. There's always gonna be someone.
First album's still there. That's always my thing. It's like, if you really love the first album,
exactly. I think that's why I realized. Like, when I didn't start. I love when, I think, he retired, remember, after When I'm Gone. And I was like, he should have just stayed retired. Because I don't like any of this new stuff that much in comparison to his old stuff. But his old stuff's still there. And and it's even better than you thought it was. You know what I mean? But I always just like, obviously we grew up for Eminem. We were born in 92 and 3. But like obviously we didn't know what was going on, how Eminem was shaping like pop culture at the time. Like, imagine living through that. This white rapper coming from Detroit just like blowing up, absolutely blowing up, to the point where like people were protesting him.
Yeah,
when he plays in venues and she's like, what the fuck's that about? Like,
and it's funny because he's in that genre of music that you like no one understands unless you're a rap fan. Like, so my dad or something would not appreciate this whatsoever, does not understand this, what this is, doesn't understand the quality of writing those songs and the ability to shape words like that and speak like that and talk like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's like, oh no, Elvis. And like, oh, Elvis is amazing stuff, but I love Eminem as a kid growing up. And then dad was like, you can't, that's not music.
Yeah.
So he always had that.
Yeah, like, no, it is 100%.
He grew up in that like genre where only certain people understand rap music.
Which is good. That I always think, I'm so glad I was born in the era of hip-hop. Because if I was like my dad's age and he'd listens, like he can't. But I'm sure there's fucking 50, 60-year-olds
out there.
They are, but like the vast majority of, especially in Ireland, like if you're 50 or and above, like they don't really like hip-hop that much.
No, because if I was comparing Eminem to Elvis, the Beatles, Bob Dylan, Johnny Cash to my dad, he would laugh at me.
Yeah.
But
I think
to me, I'm like, no, I can't make that comparison.
It's also, I know, 100%. And for me, I love all them. Like, Johnny Cash is probably my favorite, and Elvis close second. Like, but like, Eminem is just, if you listen to Eminem's song, like this song, for example, and there's hundreds of other songs like this here, you know exactly what he's trying to say. You know his emotions. You're going through that. You listen and watch this video, you're going through what he went through as a child. Yeah. Even though that's art. Like, if you can make someone feel a different emotion, whether it's comedy, whether it's fucking like, you know, horror, whatever, it's fucking like shit like that there. If you can make someone feel that emotion for fucking 3 or 4 minutes, that is fucking, I listen to Elvis and I love Elvis, like, but Elvis has never made me feel like that. Or whatever Eminem has made me feel sometimes. Like,
yeah.
I listen to Eminem's song, I'm like, fuck, that is deep.
Yeah.
That part where I'm like almost rethinking my life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
The difference between like this and his new stuff, and like it's I don't mean to harken back, because some of his new stuff is amazing. Like, some of his lyrics, his ability, like, there's no like trick. There's no tricks in this. It's just a straight story of me rapping, and this is what it is. His new stuff is very bar heavy. It's very low to cadences. It's changing his voice up and down, and it's amazing. It's so skillful. But I think for a casual listener, it's really easy to miss what Eminem's talking about now.
Yeah.
Like, he has to, whereas his old stuff, I feel like he kept it more simple, and it was easy for people to understand. But if you're a real fan of rap and ability to like rhyme schemes and stuff like that, there's no one better than him at the moment.
Yeah, and even his new stuff is like that. Yeah. But it's also, for me, I've heard it before now. So when I hear him talking about other shit now in the future, like this new album, I'm like, but I've heard you already mention that, and people say, I want you to go back to your old shit, but he already rapped about it. Why would he do it again? Why would he write another song about cleaning out my closet? But that's why I was going to be a song we're going to do next week, which I think it just shows you his level of growth as a human being, but also as a rapper, and how good he actually is, and how good he still is. Because a lot of people forget Eminem is still the best ever. Like, even to this day, his music is far better than most rappers out there. But the bad thing about it, we have a high fucking ass bar for Eminem, to the point where like I love MGK, but MGK did a decent rap devil.
Yeah.
And then we're like, oh my God, he's amazing. Like, he's never came close.
No one
has. After that, before or after us. Yeah. You know what I mean? And that was for one song. Eminem's been doing it for decades.
Yeah.
And this is said by a massive MGK fan. You know what I mean? But that's just, I'm not picking out MGK, I'm just picking out other rappers in general, where he set the bar so high that no one's going to go near him. And that's the bad thing about it. You know, you're always going to compare the new rapper to Eminem. You know, even like NF.
Yeah.
You listen to NF.
NF's
like,
getting better and better as well.
Yeah, but
he only needs 10, 20 years to
I know.
This, but
also with like, NF, if Eminem came through without Eminem being there, say Eminem never existed and then NF came through, you'd be, fuck, this is the guy who's going to fucking change rap. Eminem's done it.
Yeah.
So you're seeing some guy almost, he's not copying him, but you feel like he's just,
yeah, he's doing it in his own. The thing with NF is he's got such different values or something than Eminem and things like that. Like, he doesn't curse, he's doing something different.
Yeah.
But it's just, and as much as I really, really like him, it's still not on this level. Like, it's just not.
That's good about NF. You just do what you want to do.
Yeah.
You know, don't try to emulate or copy anyone else. Like, be true to yourself, and you'll fucking, you know, like that's what you can do. And like, in sort of music and art and shit, you know. But that was our reaction anyway. Any other Eminem, any other Eminem songs you want to react to? Let us know in the comments below. Cheers.
Hi everyone, thanks for watching the video. Please like, comment and subscribe. Just to let you know, we've got similar content available on the channel if you want to check it out.
We also do our own podcast called MC Podcasting, where we cover a range of topics from politics, sports and even movies.
We basically just talk a lot of shit.
We argue a lot as well on it there, but all the links are below. We're on all major platforms, Spotify, iTunes and is there any other?
That's the main ones, yeah.
Yeah, it's the main ones.
Just check out the podcast, and if there's any sort of videos you want us to react to, drop us a comment on the YouTube videos and we'll be sure to check it out.
Oh, if you want to make fun of us, then go ahead. We don't care.
Be nice.
Be nice.
In fairness, we don't really get that many comments.
No, I don't.
Yeah.
Stop looking at me.
Okay.